soybean harvest. Last field to do. We got deer hunters around here. I just got them done unloading my last, or second hopper, I guess you could say, off this last field I got to cut. As you guys can see, there was the 100 bushel back here. Anyway, we're down here in what I would call God's country. Got a little ways to go before I get to the actual field. Take a few minutes to get back here. As you can see, there's nothing but woods around here. The only plus thing about having a small combine, 16-foot head, I can pretty much drive anywhere I need to go. You see, I got deer hunters in front of me. I gotta go around once I get up here. Like a little 2-acre field I cut. Over there, that's a 4-acre field, but I've only cut half of it because the other half over there, I don't know if there's anything over there. It was dark when I cut that. There's a big ditch right in the middle. I'm afraid to get stuck, so I figured that'd be a daylight adventure. Why I call this like God's country down here is because you don't see a single person's house or anything within 3 or 4 miles. Like I said, if I had a bigger header and stuff, that wouldn't have happened there. It would have bottomed out. coming up here. Another deer. drug over into that big ditch in the middle of this field. It was nothing but bones left. They were still attached, but I'd say a bow hunter didn't do a very good shot. I mean, right now is the last day of deer season for open fire here in Missouri. Well, you see some deer hunters coming and going out of here. We're getting closer. There's a field right up in here. I'm not going to combine that one either. I'm leaving that one back for wildlife. This is all public wildlife hunting ground. I took a lease out on this ground here. The farm. And once I get this all cut off of here, I'll be back in here with my drill. Plant some cover crops on it. You guys can see though, it's long way back in here. This here is my 20 acre field I'm talking about, guys. So what I got done so far, 200 bushel come off of that. Probably should have been 400 bushel that I've taken off of, should have, on normal conditions, but like I said, my sprayer was broke down. Finally got to the point, I bought a new one. Well, not new, but new to me, sprayer for next year. All right, here comes the bean field. Now, put this thing back here in second gear. Fire up. But set up, get RPM. How is this machine even doing that? I mean, that is a lot of lot of grass getting swallowed up in this machine. Head loss going on, but how about ground coverage? Not really finding anything at all, which is a good thing. Most of my yield's coming from is this lower part down here. for a fact, you guys see this, this tree line over here. All that way over there. That's like standing water over there. Flatlands. Look at all this earlier, and some areas about, it was pretty small. Next time, guys.